Fox Health News reported on a new study that suggests that there is a new computer model that may help researchers better predict how long breast cancer patients will live. The model, which was developed in a research contest, uses gene signatures, and what those are sets of genes that are all turned on at the same time in a patient's cancer, to estimate how long the patient will live. So this is pretty crazy. This was all done in a contest, and this was the big winner. They said the model that the colleagues are using, given two patients, their model could predict which one would live longer 76% of the time. It also ranked patients based on how long it thought they would survive, just in general. So this is pretty intense.
It is. So of course the question is, would you want to know? Drop it. So, Jared Jackson, I'm going to go to you first. Would you want to know how long you're going to live if you had, let's just say, cancer overall, and they could determine this?
Not at all. 0%.
Wow.
Yeah.
That's strong.
Because there's a, you know, if you're fighting, I assume this is people that have been diagnosed, not people that have beat it, then they go, oh, now that you beat cancer, you have 10 years to live after this. I'm assuming that's not the case. Okay, so if you have this disease and you're trying to beat it, I don't need to know any of that. I need my brain completely and my focus and just determination.
No, just because you think, like, if they say, oh, by the way, we've determined it, and the computer says you have 3 months to live, that you're going to be like, then you're going to feel resigned that, like, we only have 3 months left rather than fighting super hard.
Well, actually, the thing is, if they tell you just without you having any real, you know, call in it, if they tell me I got 3 months, I'm thinking, well, I'm in that 26%. Fuck you. You know, that this is 74% they said, is it right?
76. Yeah.
So, I'm in the 24%. Okay. Now, it'll still piss me off and want me to go the other way, but I don't even want to have to fight something else. The odds that you're telling me I'm about to die. You know?
All right, that's interesting. Gina, thoughts?
I feel the same way. I mean, my first initial reaction was, yes, tell me. Let me be able to properly plan the rest of the time I have on this earth, and let me prioritize and figure out what's important to me and what I want to accomplish most. And thank you for the gift of letting me know what I can get done and you know, figure out what's important. But kind of like JR said, the mind is a very, very powerful thing. And I can only assume there are statistics that when someone tells you you have 6 months to live, there's probably a higher chance you're going to drop dead in 6 months than if they never told you that to begin with.
So you guys
probably in three, I think, if you accept it. You know, if they say you have 6 months to live, you start dying, you know?
Yeah.
Right.
I absolutely agree.
No, you guys make a great point, but I'm mentally stronger than that.
Mazel tov. You're the one.
Right. No, seriously, I think and I hope that I can get beyond that. I gotta know what the computer model suggests. It's not locked in stone, right? And I'm a huge believer in you can change your fate.
Absolutely.
Now, at the same time, it is an incredibly valuable piece of information.
Yeah.
Now, if we were to make this theoretical, right, and you, so because one of the things that I think is that everybody, not I think it's true, right, but most people don't think about it this way, everybody has a certain number of days that they're gonna live. Now, they don't know what that number is, but everybody's got a number,
absolutely,
right? And so I know that it flips a lot of people out thinking about what that number is, and most people, I don't know about most, but a lot of people wouldn't wanna know, right? But I would want to know, because if I have 10 days left, let me go house in those 10 days. If I've got, you know, 48 years left, I've got to plan accordingly.
Pace yourself.
Right, exactly. I got to know if I'm in a sprint or I'm in a marathon.
However,
it's very relevant to how I live.
Absolutely, and that's how I feel too. I just feel a little stronger, you know, with what JR was saying. But what about when everyone was crying death panels, and people think that you shouldn't get treatment because a computer spit out a number and said, well, you're not due to last that long anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So it's just, I don't know, it's scary.
Yeah, no, but the death panels are nonsense. That's never going to happen,
yeah.
So I wouldn't sweat that. Tim Frisch, I'm going to need backup here. If you rule against me, I lose, and I don't get to find out how long I have to live. So go.
I'd want to know to the day. As specific as you can give me, that's the information
I want. You just
want
a time code running absolutely. Next to your face.
Absolutely. Just a little countdown on my watch. I'm sure there's an app for it eventually, but yeah. That's what I want.
All right, well, we're all tied up, 2-2. Now, yesterday, Gina, in a story about Jews, had two votes because she's Jewish.
Oh.
We don't have that situation here. It's not a racial story, so we're kind of at a loss to do it, how to break a tie. Hence, we need the impaler. Okay, Vlad, we're going to need you to settle the tie here. Okay, now her actual name is Irina Nikita, but since she's often a crusher and an impaler, we go with Vlad sometimes. All right, Irina, if you can find out if you got cancer and they can tell you how long you have to live, do you want to find out or do you not want to find out?
I don't want to find out, and if I do have cancer, I would rather use other technology like turning off certain genes and other stuff that would, you know, prevent me from dying.
Nice.
I would go in that route.
Amen.
I'd stay positive.
So you guys are really into this positive thinking.
Well, but let me tell you this. This is going to, all my credibility is going to go out the window when I tell you this. However, I'm going to say it anyway.
Okay, I might take away your vote. Go ahead.
That's, I have a feeling JR's not going to appreciate this because, yeah, my vote might be canceled. But I was told by someone who considers himself a psychic when I am going to move on to off this marble, and I've kind of accepted that, and I kind of believe it.
You're insane. No, not acceptable, okay?
I mean...
Okay, look, you're fine. Your vote stands. You guys win. You don't... Nobody gets a find out.
I shouldn't
have
told you that.
TYT Supreme Court has settled that. Now, back to you for a second, okay? No, it's funny, because someone I know, I'll leave it at that, same exact thing.
Yeah.
Psychic tells them that at 33 is the magic age. They're going to die at 33. You know how old she is now?
47.
No, 35.
Oh, there you go.
Okay, gone. Bullshit. You know why? Because they're psychics, and they're all bullshit. They just tell you whatever to take your money.
Well, this wasn't like a hotline. I mean, this is somebody that is a
Oh, well, I didn't know it was a legitimate psychic.